you asking me as a domestic student, or are you asking me as a student in general?
As a student, like not a domestic.
I think come to Canada, you know, there's a lot of jobs, there's a ton of jobs. Maybe, yep. Not just my industry, every industry. What you guys go through, I would not do for myself. Mm-hmm. I would not.
How's the job market in Canada for mechanical engineering, especially if I say in Toronto, Brampton, GTA area? Hello everyone, my name is Vikram and welcome to my YouTube channel Connect with Vikram. So aaj ek aur education series ka main ek naya video leke aa raha hu. This time it's going to be a mechanical engineering department se hone wala hai and mere sath mera friend jo thodi der mein mujhe he will join me. His name is Paul and abhi main library mein hu. As you know, I'm a student of a Sheridan college. So yahan pe you can book your room, aap apna room book kar sakte ho. Private room and you can study here. So मैंने decide किया है कि मैं एक library के इसी room में ही shoot करूँगा and मैं अभी उसका wait कर रहा हूँ. I think he should be here within like few minutes I would say. तो मैं आपको room दिखाता हूँ and आपको खिड़की के बाहर का नज़ारा दिखाता हूँ. बहुत प्यारा नज़ारा है, बर्फ़ पड़ी हुई है एकदम. यहाँ का जो एक Sheridan lake है वो जम चुका है. अगर फोकस हो पाया वहाँ तक तो आई शो दैट एज वेल. सो बी टिल द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो, सारे डाउट्स क्लियर होने वाले हैं. बैक होम जितने भी स्टूडेंट हैं जिनको मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट ऑप्ट करके कनाडा आना है, एक मैं कैनेडियन पर्सपेक्टिव से, आई मीन पॉल इज़ अ कैनेडियन सिटीजन, सो कैनेडियन पर्सपेक्टिव से क्या उसके फ्यूचर एस्पेक्ट्स हैं, क्या है सब कुछ, मैं उससे बात करता हूँ एंड आई विल ट्राई टू गेट इनटू मोर डिटेल ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट. बी टिल द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो. Finally, I'm with my friend Paul. He will introduce himself a little bit and then we'll go further from here. So over to you, Paul.
My name is Paul. I am a student here at Sheridan College. I'm attending the Mechanical Engineering Technologist program. Mm-hmm. This is my last year at the program. And yeah, I'm enjoying it.
Oh yeah, so it's a 3-year program or it's a 4-year program?
This is the technologist program is a 3-year program. Mm-hmm. The technician program is a 2-year program. And the bachelor is a 3+2 program. So the technologist plus 2 more years.
So you are enrolled in
the technologist program.
That 3 years.
So 6 semester, 3-year program.
Okay, so this program comes with a co-op or?
You have the option. So you can do the technologist program with co-op, which requires you to maintain a certain GPA.
Okay.
You can do the technologist program without co-op.
Okay.
You can graduate either way. The co-op is just beneficial to you as a student as far as getting another job when you're done school.
So yeah, my next question is, how do you think the Sheridan as a college is it like a good platform for a student to start? You are getting enough opportunities.
Are you asking me as a domestic student? Are you asking me as a student in general?
As a student, like not a domestic.
I think as far as education goes, it's a great program.
Okay. And why you said as an international or domestic?
Because from what I see financially, mm-hmm. that the international students have to go through finish this program, mm-hmm. is, I wouldn't be able to finish the program if I was an international student. I would not be able to afford to finish this program. But as a domestic student, I pay half the cost, if not less than half, of a university student. Mm-hmm. I'm learning to a certain scale the same thing they are learning. Mm-hmm. The job market is just as big for a technologist as it is for an engineer. That's just from the research that I've seen. I'm currently an intern as a technologist, so jobs are there. Mm-hmm. the financial side is the only reason that I would say this program is, in my opinion, for those who are not capable of spending $17,000 to $20,000 a year on education. This is the place to be.
So pretty much for all the international students, like including me in my program, the fee is around like $18,000 per year. So
that's $18,000. That doesn't include living. That doesn't include food expenses. That doesn't include any unforeseen expenses. Mm-hmm. So you guys are coming here bleeding yourselves dry for the same education.
True.
So I would say personally, if I had to spend that money, I would not be in this program.
Okay.
I would have become a tradesman. No, I'm not joking. I would have become an electrician or a plumber or HVAC. I wouldn't have been able to pay for it. There's no way I would have gone through that.
Okay.
When in the 3 years that I've been here, I'm spending $60,000.
Mm-hmm. No, I would say near about $60,000.
That's nuts. So. And you're not working.
Yeah.
So it's $60,000 of expenses plus you don't have any income.
Mm-hmm.
That's too much money.
That's kind
that doesn't make sense for me. Like those 3 years that I could be working,
mm-hmm.
I could have put away the $60,000 and invested it towards my future. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I mean, I got your point.
Anyways,
I mean, my next question would regarding the job market. How's the job market in Canada for mechanical engineering, especially if I say in Toronto, Brampton, GTA area?
There's always gonna be jobs, and like any professional field, is gonna be a very competitive market.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't been in the industry like for 10 years, let's say. I couldn't tell you exactly how competitive it is, but
mm-hmm.
just from speaking to my new coworkers and from people who are currently engineers, such as the professors and
mm-hmm.
friends of my parents, it is a competitive field. Getting in is challenging, which is why the co-op is so important, to get that little resume
mm-hmm.
that you have experience, gets you a foot in the door.
Yeah,
gets you the great $40,000 a year initial salary, but it gets you a foot in the door. I would say there are jobs out there. I mean, if you go on LinkedIn, you'll see a fair amount of jobs, right?
Okay.
Now they usually ask for experience, and that's always the hardest part of being a young person. You pay for your youth with experience, right? Yeah, there's definitely jobs out there. It is. Life is challenging everywhere.
That's true.
it's never going to be a walk in the park,
true.
Right? But yeah, you'll definitely find work. Whether it's as a technologist or a technician, you're qualified to do both.
Yeah.
Right? So you've opened doors for yourself. You could change careers and become a millwright, tool and die. You could do that for a little bit, find a job as a technologist. You know, there are positions open. You will eventually find work. As far as my recommendation for international students, because
mm-hmm.
I've seen my classmates and my friends do this,
mm-hmm.
they come and they do the two-year program.
Yeah.
So they get the technician program, they graduate, they find employment, they get their PR,
yeah.
then they come back to school and they pay Canadian fees. And it's a lot easier to survive after doing that. So
mm-hmm.
instead of spending another year not working full-time and spending the $18,000 you said, which can be more than $18,000, right? Do the 2 years, get it over with, work, get your PR, come back and finish it. And that's what all my friends who have done this program, that's what most of them have done.
True.
So they've done the 2 years of work, then they come back with their PR, they spend the $5,000 it is to go to school for the whole year.
Because
I spend roughly $5,200 to $5,300 a year.
Oh, a year. That's like
that's
a lot
it.
Of different. Because
that's half of your semester.
Yeah. True.
Right? So for me,
like
for me, and I work two jobs, for me, the $5,000, yeah, I mean, it's a lot of money, but and as far as like what you guys are spending, I can pay that and not have to take out a loan.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'm still tight on budget, right? Like I don't have money, but I'm able to afford that every year without having to go to the bank and take out $20,000 against my name.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so that's where like the big difference is. Now when I finish school, I still have a little bit of debt, but it's super manageable. It's not like I have $60,000 to pay off, right?
True.
So yeah, that's my recommendation. Take advantage of the system.
Mm-hmm.
You know, be in school, get a piece of paper, get a job, get your PR, then come back.
Okay.
You know, that's the That's the smart way of doing it.
Smart way.
Right? Because you work for 2 years, you save your money, you come back, you relax, you don't have to worry. Like, you can breathe a little bit easier.
Mm-hmm.
A few friends of mine, they put away like 40 grand in the 2 years they worked.
Okay.
They come back to school.
Mm-hmm.
They can pay their rent without having to work. They can focus on school full time.
True.
And they're paying their fees cash. They can just pay their fees.
Yep.
And they still have money left over. Not fucking do it. Cut that out.
That's fine.
I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't drop everything, move to a different country just to get hosed financially for the same degree that someone else is paying a quarter the price for. No, that's not fair.
So yeah, that's for my audience. That as per Paul's experience, is more focusing on getting the 2 year program, enroll yourself in the 2 year program, and then get a PR, work for few years, like full time, save money, utilize that money. I mean, you can focus more on the studies. You just have to pay 1/4 of what the Canadian students are paying. So that's kind of fees. If I'm paying,
that's not even including OSAP grants.
Yeah.
So that's $5,300 you'd be spending a year. That's the two semesters. That doesn't include the OSAP grants that are available, which are you don't have to pay back.
Yeah.
The loans you pay back, the grants you don't pay back. So it might be less than $5,300 once you get your PR.
So yeah, so OSAP is Ontario Scholarship Program. So if you get the grant from the OSAP, then you don't have to pay for your tuitions. Government pay for it.
If they give you that much. Yeah. Sometimes it's a lot less.
I mean, whatever amount they grant.
It's still always very helpful.
Yeah, even you get the loan as well, which you have to pay after graduating, I think.
You have six months after graduating to start paying back your loan without any penalties. So if you have, let's say, $10,000 worth of fees, by the time you finish, that's what you owe, and you're able to save up $10,000 in 6 months, which is crazy. Let's just say in a perfect world you save $10,000 in 6 months, you would pay that without any interest.
So yeah, it's like that that SBI Bank student loan, which actually starts after finishing your studies. But here is a trick that they also provide the grants. If not loan, then grant as well. So that grant you don't have to pay back. Depends on them how much percent they will give you grant. So yeah, I mean, that's a good opportunity after getting the PR. I would definitely recommend. And we talk about the job market, the co-op.
I think the key to being an immigrant in Canada is to get your PR.
Yeah.
Because it allows you to get on the healthcare system. It allows you to get on the educational system.
Yeah.
It allows you to get on the OSAP grants. So you maybe for you 2 years is too long. You can find a 1 year program here. I don't know how easy it is, and I don't know how easy it is to apply to a 1 year program and get in.
Right? You just have to convince to the visa officer that why you want to come. Your reasons should be there.
Maybe do the 1 year program, work, get your PR, come back and start a new program.
Yep.
But as a Canadian, right?
As a Canadian,
with all the benefits that come with being Canadian, right?
True.
And like, rest easy knowing that anytime you break your leg, you don't have to pay a fucking dollar.
Yeah, true.
Sorry.
You don't have to pay. Government take care of everything.
Yeah, you might pay $35 for the cast.
Yeah.
If you need an ambulance, it's about another $35 for the ambulance.
Yeah, true.
It's nothing, true. You know? And like, on top of that, now you have student fees. You can do the OSAP loan, so you don't even have to pay your fees right away.
Yeah.
You can just focus on school. Do what you need to do, work on the weekends, sometimes work after school, but mainly focus on your schooling. Get that done, start your life.
That's incredibly true. I mean, over the 1.5 years, ever since I'm in Canada, I've experienced the biggest, you know, stress for a student, international student, is to get the fee paid, you know, to pay that fee.
You guys pay so much money for these programs, and like,
So having said that, here I'm towards the end of my video. It was nice talking with you. Thank you for taking out time for me and other audience.
Thanks for having me on.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, that's my pleasure. You know, always. Whatever your questions are there, you can put down. You know, write down the comment below. I'll try to answer most of them.
If you have any questions for me, Vikram knows where to find me.
Definitely. And, I'll just ask him, man, you know.
He'll throw it back in the comments.
Yeah, true. And yeah, so I think that was the crux of our today's conversation, is to get the PR first, get to 2 years of education first, work for a while, save money, utilize that money. When you will,
use the system, utilize the system. The system is there, use it, come to Canada. You know, there's a lot of jobs, there's a ton of jobs. Maybe, not just my industry, every industry. Ton of jobs. It's it's a growing country, right?
Yeah, maybe like IT.
It's cold though. Yeah. It's cold. it's cold here.
Yeah, it's definitely very cold.
Yeah, but you get used to it. You get used to it. Buy a car. Don't walk.
Pay the fee first and then buy the car.
Yeah, don't walk.
All right, Paul. Thank you so much.
No problem.
See you in next video. Till then, connect with Vikram.